Vinyl Guru in the house.
Love
Dr. The Loopy, Dr. Loops, Mr. Dots and Loops, okay? Here on the 70s Game Show Match Game.
Love it. Love it.
I'm sure at this point you probably know how the games, the rule of the game work, you know? But if you don't
know. All over it.
Here we go.
Let's shabba-dabba do it.
Let's shabba-do it, okay? I have questions. He has answers. Hopefully we match or else, old women at the, you know, retirement house have to listen to Robin Thicke for 2021. Shit. No pressure.
Tears will be flowing if we're not knowing.
But listen, I don't do this alone, honey, because I do have my illustrious Cher.
Cher's in the house. Gypsies, Tramps, and Thieves.
Yes, her best record. She knows it. But, you know, she's always held here captive, forcefully.
I'm behind you 100%.
Anyway.
You look great, by the way. Just like you.
Oh,
Vinyl Guru, you're going straight to the top. Everybody knows that. The Vinyl Guru, the Vinyl
honey,
Guru.
If that's the case, I'm dragging you to the mountain with me, honey.
All right, let's do it.
If anybody's got a mountainous ride, it's BC people. Yes, he's from Vancouver, people. Oh, honey. All right, so you know what? Let me just dive in, okay? Lubing you up here, favorite color. Now, I went red because you're fiery heat. Anything close? Yes? No?
Do it. You know what? It's a little love. It's a little orange-colored skies.
Damn.
Look at that. There's a little orange on this piece of paper, too. It's orange.
Honey, orange.
But you know what? I love the red, too. I love... You know what, though? You're close because it's a hot color. And I like the heat. I like the heat.
You know what? It's true. And you need a little bit of red and yellow to make orange. That's a half point.
Good start.
All right, baby. Hold on. Let's see if I'm going to get this. I know you're you're a bit of a movie person, too. So let's see.
Oh, I love the movies.
Yeah. So I went, favorite movie. I went Eyes Wide Shut.
A little Kubrick. Now, I do love my Stanley Kubrick, don't you know? As a matter of fact, one of my all-time favorite Kubrick movies is 2001, The Space Odyssey. But I also love his first movie, which was an adaptation from a Jim Thompson novel called The Killing, which is about a heist at a racetrack. But you're right, I am a massive movie freak and movie nut, as I sense you are. And to ask me my favorite movie is impossible. It's an impossible task. So I have to tell you my favorite movie this week.
Oh, okay. Hit me, babe.
That I watched.
We like that.
And unlike his massive hit movies, Scarface and Untouchables, which I like, I'm a big De Palma fan. Big De Palma fan. And so I watched the 1980, I believe it is, John Travolta, Nancy Allen classic, Blowout.
Oh, shoot. Not even close, but close enough because you blew me out of the water here. Blowout indeed. Nice.
Blowout.
Blowout. I got to check that out, babe.
You got to check it out. It's a mashup of Blow Up, which featured the Yardbirds. But Blowout, underrated. I'm just going to tell you that. Underrated.
Checking it, babes. All right. So I also know you're a bit of a sports fan. And I could just tell. I could just your aura, honey. Look at those shoulders, honey. Those shoulders told me everything I needed. Okay, so with favorite sport, I definitely was either gonna go rugby or this football. Ow! I could tell.
Imagine.
Those shoulders told me everything I needed, honey. I'm telling you. Those blades.
The football action. You are right, Vinyl Guru.
Now,
I do love sports.
What are some of your favorite football teams, babes?
So, you know, being from north of the border, as you are, you got to love all the teams that are close to the 49th parallel. So you got to go with your Buffalo Bills, your mini Vikings, your mighty... The birds of the West, the Seattle Seahawks. And I know we're going to get a lot of shade thrown on us because there's a lot of heavy NFL fans out there, but you got to go with those northern teams, I say. What about you? Are you a football fan?
You know what? I'm more of a footy fan, so close enough. I do love my football, you know what I mean? But yeah, I love to watch football. I don't know about playing it, honey. Woo! It's a bit tactical for me. But listen, Eddie. I mean, ding, ding, ding. You will never know how hard it is to match on this thing. So, yes.
You did it.
The waves indeed.
Behold.
Let's keep swimming, honey. Let's keep swimming.
Do it.
Psych label that you adore. Now, I kind of went a little bit more conservative on this one because, I mean, like, it is in your logo. So I did, okay. I went Virgo, but then I wrote uni here. I was like, or uni, because I know your logo is uni. So hard.
Both awesome choices.
Too hard.
And you really had me working the cranium muscles, the pulsating. I was like that guy in Star Trek with the cage. The brain was like, it was like pulsating, baby. But no, so there's a lot of labels. Even like Columbia, you know, had United States of America. I watched your match that you did, and you're right, Columbia. So many artists on Columbia. Epic, had the Head Shop, I think, and they also had CAC. There's so many great labels, but I had to go. I had to go with mainstream, because mainstream was so. They had so many psychedelic bands on there. Of course, Amboy Dukes, but then they had Bohemian Vendetta. They had Stone Circus. They had the
Stone
Growing
Circus
Concern.
Were mainstream. Oh, I didn't know that.
It's
honey, I didn't know the others, but I knew Stone Circus. So hey, bam. And yeah, you're right about United States being on Columbia. Yeah, there were certain psychedelic bands that were on Columbia that did kind of break through.
It's almost like every label, Vinyl Guru, if you agree, it almost seems like at that time they tried to grab psychedelic bands, right? Like even MGM had Ultimate Spinach and ABC Probe, you know, had Morgan and like all these. I don't know if they always knew what to do. True. Capitol. Had SRC
did it for a hot second though. I don't think they did it as well as, but you're right. It was a moment in time. But the thing is about the psych bands is like, everybody, it was like one or two records, you know, that's the only thing about it, right? That's the only thing, but okay.
It was a fleeting time and it was like a passing romance. It was like a hot weekend.
Hot summer flings, yes, hot and heavy, which is why we love them. But you know, gotta catch it while it's hot. It's true.
Like a shooting star.
Yes, dear, and you're a star, you are. I caught him, folks.
I got you.
Yes, caught you good. Now listen, most you've spent on an illustrious record.
Is that what we are? Are we on most we spent, or are we on city that you want
wait,
to
wait,
dig
wait.
In?
We're on a. See, I'm. You've blown my mind so much at this point. I skipped one. Oh my goodness. Favorite city to road trip on? Because I know you're a bit of a. He likes to trek it, folks. So I don't know. I went Portland.
I have to say, you couldn't have gone wrong with either. And this is the hint, of course. I'm going to go Mazzy on this one. We're going to go Emerald City again. We're going to go Seattle. So half marks because, you know, either Portland or Seattle, you're right. I love both those cities. I get to go to both those cities quite frequently. And I love them both. And so Portland, Seattle. I had written down Portland and I changed it to Seattle. So you know what? You still get a half mark.
Half point. Ding, ding, ding.
Okay, you can sleep well tonight.
I'm happy to hear it, baby.
Yeah,
no, but you know what? Have you been to that town?
Have you been to Seattle or Portland?
I'm dying to. I heard that there's really, you can find really obscure shit on the cheap there. It's crazy. Like, they have a lot of great garage shit there. It's really crazy.
Yeah, I have to say, in my opinion, Portland is a better digging city. They have some amazing record stores. Seattle does too, but Portland is really good.
And do they have more record stores there than Seattle as well, or no?
I think they do. Yeah. Seattle has a lot, but Portland seems to have a few more, and I would suggest they've got, from what I've seen, a little bit better in terms of pricing and also in terms of selection.
And yet he still picked Seattle. Give him shit, folks. Give him shit. All right, so most you've spent on a record. Okay.
Listen, it's a lot.
It's going to be a lot, which is why I went out. Because I know.
Well, it's a lot. You know what? any amount that you spend, but really, can you spend too much on a record?
If it's something you love, screw it. But the reason why I like to ask this is because people are nosy, okay? Not only do they want to know how much, but they want to know what it is. So you better have that out soon.
So I'll say something about buying records, which I've done all my life, but certainly in the year 1999, I started buying like a fiendishly amount of records. And I still buy a lot of records here and there. And as you collect more, prices go up, you spend more money. There's no doubt, because condition matters more. You look for certain things. It doesn't mean you're not picky. And I'm sorry to go on about a big soliloquy here. So I'll just show the number.
It's 750 bones. I went 3 for you, but 7.
Oh, yeah, you didn't show yet. 3. Yeah, I went 7.
Okay, I'm dying to know what it is.
A little face like, what the, what?
Oh, honey, we all know. This, you know what she spreads on her face? She spreads like Rolls Royce gas on her toast. So she ain't even one to judge.
I have been a freaking diva
listen,
for 40 freaking
I
want to
know
years.
What that record is, please.
You know
let
what?
The people know. You have
I'm going to tell the people, tune in on Dots and Loops, and I'll show the record. Is that bad?
He's
That's bad,
smart.
Isn't it?
This is why
but,
we love
crafty.
It. This is why we
it's
adore
Dots and Loops crafty. So, you know what? I will show that record on an upcoming video.
Oh, he's a strip teaser, folks. It's why we adore you. Get your tassels out. We look forward to it, honey. Yeah, you let us know. Now, a genre that you are a bit of a novice at, I don't know. I don't really see you show this too much. Maybe I've missed it, but I went jazz.
Ah, that's a good one. It's a good one. And you know, the wife, Mrs. Dotson Loop, she is a massive jazz head. So there's lots of jazz albums in the house, and it could have been in there, or you could have just said anything post 2000. But I gotta go classical.
Interesting.
I like my Brahms and I like my opera every now and then. But you know what? If you're really to ask me, if you're to talk to like Sound Strange or some of these guys, these guys that they know about classical music, Chris Keebler, these guys, they know so much. And I got nothing. I got Brahms, I got Mozart, I got Amadeus. That's it, man.
Another one I would shout out is Poetry on Plastic. I think he's phenomenal. He knows his classical too. Okay, Amadeus, you make me laugh. Okay, hold on. What's a genre you can never get into? I know this is a bit scandalous, but another one I barely see, you know, mentioned. So I guess bluegrass.
I wish you actually were here to write that down, because that's what I would have written down. You're right. No! I know nothing. So where's my pen? I'll write that in there. Where's my pen? I'll change my answer.
This is going to be edited real quick, okay, folks? You're not seeing anything.
I said none, because you want to know why? I do. That's a lame. I said none. But I also put symphonic Prague and some country. I don't know. It's so hard.
That is
so
the worst
country
question.
Country is kind of bluegrass, because you're right. I don't – bluegrass. Bluegrass and me, we don't –
It takes a particular like frequency to appreciate too, by the way. That's why certain people, they love most genres except certain ones like country or whatever, because it does, it's a frequency thing. That's a whole other video, but yeah. Okay, what's a group you collect all their albums of, or at least try to? Now, this is tough for somebody like you, because most of the stuff you collect, I feel like they, like again, like we've discussed this, they have kind of one-off records, so I kind of went with probably the most mainstream psych band of all time, The Doors. I don't know.
Damn, that's a good answer. And you would have been right, because I also went with a mainstream answer, which was The Beatles.
Yeah, that's true too. Another great psych-ish band. But yeah, totally. More pop.
Sorry, go ahead, Vinyl Guru.
No.
Cut out a bit.
It's Mr. Roboto, yes. No, I just said they had like moments, you know, where they tickled it, I suppose, you know.
They tickled it, you're right. And I do love me my Beatles, absolutely love. And The Doors is a great answer as well, because I do have all their albums, and that's a super super fantastic dancer. So,
I wouldn't. My second choice would have been Love, actually. So I wouldn't have gotten that either way. Shoot. Well, sorry, folks. He likes his beats with the Beatles. Okay, so a major city that you've always wanted to dig. Well, now that I know you've basically penetrated all of the West, I didn't even bother to tickle there, but I did anyway. I should have not went here because, well, whatever. Yeah?
And I, you know what? And I love it. I've dug there. That wasn't it. I gotta go east or
yeah,
sort of.
Shit. I thought maybe it was a city.
I gotta go to the windy city.
Oh, Chicago.
Chicago.
Chi-town is an amazing place to dig. Oh my gosh. That is
Chicago. On State Street, that great street, I just gotta say. Hey, we gotta go to Chicago, man.
Honey, you got some pops. You can slap some pipe on here, honey. And we're not talking about plumbery. Anyways.
You know what? I love to go to Chicago. I hear great things. And my son went there a couple of years ago, and the pictures look amazing. Downtown Chicago with the river flowing through and the architecture.
The
love
architecture
to go to Chicago
is really,
one day.
It's really, yes, it's quite coppery and gorgeous. I think, but regardless, I think the people have really wide range of taste. I think you'd really love it in Chi-town. Oh my gosh. What? Come on, brain fart. Have you ever been to New York, by the way?
I have not. Never.
Another really great place to dig, but not so much for the psych thing, I think. More for, I'll have to show you some spots. By the way, some places that did have that kind of stuff closed. Too many places closed in New York. It's dreadful. Oh, anyway.
Yeah, that's
terrible. But listen, you know what's not terrible?
The local record stores.
Yes.
Right?
Definitely.
Get out there and support those guys. It's big time.
Yes, and speaking of support, people, please, you know what to do. Slap him some love. Go stalk him. He's a lovely human being.
Back at you, Vinyl Guru. You're going straight to the top. Everybody knows that. We love what you're doing, and you're pure fire. You're on fire right now, and keep it up.
I have an agenda to push, and the agenda has a lot of... It's groovy, baby. It's groovy.
It's good. It's a good thing. It's a good agenda.
It's real groovy.
Goodness. What is that? I can't see. I'm getting...
I'm just saying it's a groovy agenda.
Sparkle and shine.
Oh, honey. We're so sparkly. So sparkly that we gotta know this is how we say...
Whoa!
Woo! We out here to blind. Anyways, so yeah. I'll tell you, darling, what you would have won if you went further.
He would have won a size 8 and a size 12 shoe from Amazon's cousin online retailer, Amazonia.
What?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Now,
we matched one. What do we get for that?
We had two, babes. We had two.
Two at least.
Because we did them half points.
That's solid.
Solid indeed.
The yin and the yang.
The yin and the yang. Now, you know how I end my shit, honey. Are you going to do this?
Peanut and butter.
Are you doing this with me or what? Are you toodalooing with me?
Toodaloo. Toodaloo. The Battle Guru.
Oh, gotta love him. The loopy dots and loops. Okay.
Battle Guru!
Ooh, you ready for the sparkle fingers? Oh shit, the witch Jim Morrison hands are coming out.
The tentacles! The tentacles!
Love it! Oof! San Fran! Damn it!